Forget out-of-towners, Goldie Hawn says she's met out-of-worlders. The iconic actress reveals she once had an encounter with extraterrestrials.
Good morning, everybody. It is the weekend. This is the Saturday edition because I missed so many episodes last week. I want to make sure you guys get videos for me as much as possible. Let's hope.
Goldie said that when she was living in California in her 20s, there were lots of UFO sightings, and she hoped to have one of her own. Recalling of one stargazing night, all I could think of was, how far does this go? How little are we? Are we the only planet in the whole wide universe that has life on it? And then I said, I know you're out there. I know we're not alone. And I would like to meet you one day.
I don't believe that she would just say to space, oh, guys, I want to meet you so bad, blah, blah, blah. And then aliens come down and touch her on the face. Like, eh, you know, it's a little bit much even for me. And I'm a fucking nut.
It seems that her wish was soon granted. When a few months later, she went to sleep in a friend's car after a long dance rehearsal. And the next thing she knew, she was hit with a sound. Goldie said, I got this high-pitched sound in my ear. It was this high, high frequency. And I looked out the window and I saw these two or three triangular shaped heads.
I have a high pitched sound in my ear all the time. It's called ringing in the ears, Goldie, ringing in the ears. It was this high, high frequency, she said. And I looked out the window and I saw these two or three triangular shaped heads. They were silver in color, slash for a mouth, tiny nose, no ears, triangle heads. I haven't heard this one before, as it has to do with the UFO phenomenon.
They were silver in color, slash for a mouth, tiny little nose, no ears. They were pointing at me in the car as if they were discussing me, like I was a subject, and they were droning. She went on, I could not move, I was paralyzed, and I thought, oh my God, I want to get up. I didn't know if it was real or not real. And finally, I burst out of it. It was like bursting out of a force field.
Have you ever hoped an alien would come out of the sky and touch your face? I don't ask for things like that because you never know what you might get. But let's continue and see why this old story is coming up now.
I got emotional, tear here and there, and said, I don't understand it, but I did have an experience once that had to do with maybe being visited by someone. The astrophysicist started asking her questions about her experience and what the beings looked like, and reflecting on it triggered a long-forgotten memory from that encounter. Goldie explained, it was like kind of regression therapy or something. I am like almost in a trance. And then suddenly I remembered something. They touched my face.
You know, this is back when mescaline and blotter and psychedelics were in heavy use. So who knows what the circumstances are having to do with Goldie Hawn being touched by an alien with a triangle head. But hey, sounds kind of cool.
The actress also revealed that she once dreamed of the mountainside, then went to see a crop circle that had appeared nearby and realized it was the same location from her dream. Plus, the crop circle was in the shape of a heart. She said, I have collected hearts my whole life. I built a house of hearts. I have done everything with hearts. And I looked at this and I thought, I don't know anything, but if this is a sign, I'll take it.
Okay, so let's break this down. A crop circle in the form of a heart. And it was put there specifically for Goldie because they wanted to send her a signal. And what better way to do it than make a crop circle with hearts?
77-year-old recalls a time in her early 20s when she was sleeping in a friend's car while working as a dancer in California, saying, I got this high-pitched sound in my ear.
I'm sorry, folks. She was sleeping in a car, and she looked out the window and saw three triangular heads. 40 years ago, I mean, I would go screaming like a little bitch right out of the freaking other window or drive away or something. That's some good acid, guys. That's really good acid.
Saw these two or three triangular shaped heads. The Overboard star describes the aliens as being, quote, silver with a slash for a mouth and a tiny little nose. Goldie continues, they were pointing at me in the car as if they were discussing me, like I was a subject and they were droning.
Okay, so pointing is a characteristic of human behavior. We point when we want to show something or give directions or something like that. But would the aliens point? Would that even be in their pool bag? Point at Goldie Hawn and the three of them are talking about her outside the car window?
I could not move. I was paralyzed. despite thinking in the moment that she'd, quote, made contact with outer space.
She actually turned and looked out the window, so she couldn't have been paralyzed. So I don't know where this is coming from, but let's keep going and see what they say.
Despite thinking in the moment that she'd, quote, made contact with outer space, First Wives Club actress says she chalked it all up to a dream.
I could chalk it up to a bunch of other things. Look, don't get me wrong. I constantly talk about aliens. I believe there are alien races throughout whatever space is. But I believe it's all beyond our understanding. I think there is information most certainly coming out now in the United States Congress and Senate. The Pentagon has been ordered to release stuff. Slowly, stuff is coming out.
It was the most benevolent, loving feeling. This was powerful. It was filled with light.
Benevolent, loving feeling. Okay.
This was powerful. It was filled with light.
It was filled with light. So the beings are filled with light. They had gray uniforms, according to her. And, you know, she's been saying recently, especially on a blog or a radio blog she did the other day, that we can never lose our wonder.
We cut ourselves off from a lot of things. If we're continuing to deny something that we have no proof over, there's a lot of things in this world that we can't see, but we can't stop believing. We can never, ever lose our wonder. It's just no fun. It's really an important aspect of being an adventurer, where nothing is impossible.
Don't never have to worry about anything, right? Everything is all set for her, right? So, of course, she's not going to lose her wonder, but what about all the poor people? I don't think they have wonder, guys. I don't think, you know, even middle class, there's no freaking wonder, okay?
It's just no fun. It's really an important aspect of being an adventurer where nothing is impossible.
Everything is impossible. If you try to do anything that Goldie Hawn does, do you think you'll be successful? Of course not. She's Goldie Hawn and we're nobodies. Oh boy. Okay, guys, thanks for hanging out today. It's a Saturday edition. I hope you liked it. And if you did, hit that like and subscribe and share it on your social media. As you can tell, I don't ask you to like and subscribe all through the video. I put little subscribe buttons up to remind you. Have a good day. We'll see you on Monday.